Hello everyone, this is Dilip working as a project manager in Brick&Bolt. Today I'm going to tell you about RCC, that is reinforced cement concrete, which is used in the building construction. Most often people are unfamiliar with the materials which is used for the construction. So although it is an optional thing to know, but if you know about a major components which have been used, that would help you like in a budget friendly way. So RCC is a composite materials of both concrete and steel reinforcement. RCC is a most usable term which is used in the house construction. Going to the RCC in depth, the concrete varies according to the quality and proportion what we are using it. Concrete cannot attain a maximum tensile strength. Although it is good at compressive strength, but it couldn't attain the maximum tensile strength. To overcome this problem, we add steel reinforcement to the RCC, to the concrete. So which is summing up to the RCC structure, because steel have highest, have more tensile strength compared to all other materials. Going forward, we have main properties of RCC, like it should have a ability to withstand adequate compressive strength, tensile strength, and even the shear forces, and it shouldn't show excessive deviation which would spoil the serviceability, and it should be of good fire and weather resistance. The reinforcement should have good covering so that we can avoid the corrosion of steel, and the air cracks formed should be within the permissible limit. So further, we have advantages and disadvantages of RCC. So the major advantages of RCC are, it is more durable and less maintenance cost. And coming up, RCC structures are more feasible for fire resistance, and even RCC structures, construction of steel structures is consuming more time, whereas construction of RCC structures is can be done within a limited time period. These are the major advantages. Coming up to the disadvantages of RCC, we don't seem to see like many disadvantages of RCC. Construction of RCC involve many steps like casting, mixing, then vibrating, everything. Whereas in steel structures, we don't have any of this follows. If you fail to follow any of these steps while doing the RCC concrete, it may get lost in the structural strength. Going forward, the other disadvantages is, if there is any shrinkage on the RCC slab which is already hardened up, there may be a loss of structural loss, or there may be a further strength loss. The major type of steel reinforcement used in RCC is TMT bars. TMT stands for thermomechanically treated reinforcement bars. These bars are produced by quenching red hot steel with adequate supply of water, which will end up with maximum tensile strength of the bars. So we usually get Fe415, Fe500, Fe550, Fe600, which is the iron content present in the TMT bars. Preferably we use Fe500 and Fe550 for the residential buildings in Brick&Bolt. RCC or PCC, which is a better one? Usually RCC is the most sustainable term which is used in house construction. It can withhold high tensile strength compared to PCC. PCC is a weaker substance which is only used for flooring and even for external surfaces, whereas RCC has the ability to withhold all the structural strength for the building. We prefer RCC for the construction of residential building, commercial, or any industrial building. RCC is the preferable term. In the home, the most popular and safest concrete mix for RCC's columns we use is M25, that is 1:1:2, that one sum up to one pot of cement, one pot of sand, and two pot of aggregates. This is a technically strong and durable concrete mix which is preferable for RCC structures for house construction. Going forward, RCC slab is nothing but reinforced cement concrete slab, which is a durable one and which is a commonly used term in the building construction, which is supported by beams and columns to maximum strength. And usually in a residential building, the RCC slab varies with the thickness of 5 to 6 inches. we have different types of slab. The one is one-way slab, the other is two-way slab, which is used in a normal building construction. One-way slab, we have structural strength towards the shortest direction, whereas in two-way slab, we can attain the structural strength in both the directions. Coming up to the curing part, curing is the major part which is done after the RCC slab is casted. Curing is nothing but maintaining the adequate temperature, adequate stability for the concrete which is already casted on the slab. So curing take plays a major role in RCC casting. With sufficient moisture, the cementitious material in the concrete react to produce a high yield strength final product. Curing thus concludes the RCC slab casting process.